I couldn't imagine until I walked up and saw that this room was black, and I knew.
Said, "I have the lights off, damn it."
But I would also like to thank the Lord for bringing me to this point in my life. And in speaking about my husband, that man gave me so much love. After he's gone and his son will be made, we've been 15 years, I'm still living off that love.
Jesus, right? Jesus.
Because I could not go and find anyone. I ain't got time to re-raise somebody else's son.
Yes, yes, yes.
But I knew when to get out of the way. And you know, you around a husband that you know when you're going to push him to the left. Janice, you know what I'm talking about. You know when to back up, don't you? I did that. I ain't got time to reprogram one. But my husband was a loving man. And sometimes I often wonder, Charlie, what is Sheila got on you to make you jump when she hollers? I told you not to do that. But he loved him some Sheila and some Eddie and some Media.
Yes,
I used to see him and Media go at it like cats. He'd be trying to tell Media how he wanted a certain thing done. And Media would get aggravated, turn red, and say, "I'm a child of this, should have been done this way, but boy, did I tell you to do it that way." And you would think today when they get to work and they were coming back, that Media wouldn't be back in that truck with him no more. The very next day, what would you think? I got maybe he was in there. I said, "Now, I swore Media would not be food." But he left a legacy in our family. And matter of fact, our whole family back in the day was tight and close. Jess, I'm going to tell you a story about your family and how I love your family. Your mom and I was bosom buddies. You knew that. Your mama was handling kids back to back. And I'm like, "You got this thing." And I would put her kids and take them to the hospital, and the doctor would not let your brother and sister go home. Three different cases. And I said to her, "And why do you keep having these kids?" She said, "If you would go and get this one out, when Billy Hugh come home, I'm gonna get your money back. I wouldn't pay for your brother to come home. Billy, you never came back." So I went on again. She was back up there, doctor, judge, had him again. "Hey, when you come up here, I gotta get my baby. Dr. Judge won't let me have him." I said, "Aunt Ruth, Billy, you ain't came back from my last one." "We bring that one home." And I laughed when your brother and thing, I told Sheila on the thing, I said, "I wonder do they know they still owe me coming home."
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
That's how we loved each other. If we had it, you can have it.
And we were
taught that way. We were just loving family. But and through it all, I wouldn't take nothing from my family. They make me mad. They know they make me mad. I don't hide it. That's just, and they don't hide theirs. But it never lasts no more than, I guess when you're on the phone and think about it, we'll be back in the same mode again. But I love my family. I wouldn't take nothing from them. There's not a one of them that I can say that I don't get along with them. They know me.
Amen.
They know I'm crazy. I'm just going to be honest with you. They know I'm crazy. Yes.
Well, hallelujah, Lord.
But I do thank all of you for coming. I love you. And I wouldn't take them for the day. Oh, and my brother-in-law was sitting there.
I've been in this family so long with your brother.
And he ain't got 2 points. But it's, I wouldn't take nothing for the raising. And even back when we were coming along, you didn't mess with relatives. Do you have to
look at me? Amen, amen.
You could go out and start showing out or cutting up or whatever. Lord, she's making me so mad. She couldn't keep me. Like, I'm telling y'all, she really beat me. And we, you know, back in the day, we would have to sit at the table. And we would get at the table. Mom, Jeanette, she did this right here. I don't even know why she keep messing with that girl. You know what I'm saying? And I'm saying, Lord, why don't you just shut up? Just shut up. But she couldn't keep nothing. She would wait till we get at that table. Everything get quiet and she start telling on me.
Okay.
She cannot keep nothing.
Is that right, Lois?
But I want to tell you, I really enjoy what you all know. Even though I'm not the one for this type, I will always say, don't do this stuff for me. But they don't listen to me. They don't listen to me. I'll be trying to do something.